In the second part of Maths chapter Graphical Solutions, we will solve the linear equations in two variables graphically, or simultaneous linear equations graphically. For that, it is simple. We will make truth tables, two truth tables separately for both the equations, fill them with the help of calculations. We have already got the coordinates by filling the truth table. We will plot those coordinates one by one on the graph paper, draw the lines passing through them, and wherever these two lines intersect, that point's coordinate is the solution of the two equations. Like we used to solve linear equations in two variables or simultaneous linear equations with the substitution method or equating the coefficients or cross multiplication. This is the fourth method which you can use to solve linear equations in two variables. Okay, let's start with the first question. We have two equations, 3x minus 2y is equal to 4 and 5x minus 2y is equal to 0. We have to solve both these equations graphically. So first let's take the first equation, 3x minus 2y is equal to 4. So we will start solving it by drawing a truth table. So we have x, y, 0, 1, minus 1 are the values of x. So when x is equal to 0, these values are taken by us. Now you know very well. When x is equal to 0, 3 multiplied by 0 minus 2y is equal to 4. So minus 2y is equal to 4 because 3 multiplied by 0 is 0. So y is equal to 4 by minus 2. So y is equal to minus 2. When x is 0, y is minus 2. When x equals 1. When x equals 1, 3 bracket 1 minus 2y is equal to 4. So 3 minus 2y is equal to 4. So minus 2y is equal to 4 minus 3. So minus 2y is equal to 4 minus 3 is 1. 4 minus 3 is 1. So minus 2y is equal to 1. So y is equal to 1 by minus 2, that is minus 0.5. Next, when x is equal to minus 1, 3 bracket minus 1 minus 2y is equal to 4. So minus 3 minus 2y is equal to 4. Minus 2y is equal to 4 plus 3. Minus 2y is equal to 7. And y is equal to 7 by minus 2, which is minus 3.5. So when x is minus 1, y is minus 3.5. So I will, without any delay, plot these points on the Cartesian plane and get my equation ready. Okay, get my graph ready for the first equation, and then I'll plot the second equation. So let's plot the graph for the first equation, 3x minus 2y. 3x minus 2y is equal to 4. That is our equation, right? So what coordinates did we get? I hope you noted it down. I have noted them down. 0, comma, minus 2. 0, comma, minus 2. Then second pair of coordinates are 1, comma, minus 0.5. 1, comma, minus 0.5. And third coordinate is minus 1, comma, minus 3.5. Okay, so I know that you can't see these coordinates. Now you will be able to see them. Can you see them? Okay, so these are three coordinates which we just talked about. Now we will draw a straight line passing through all the three coordinates. Here you go. The straight line. Okay, so we have one of our graph ready. Now let's do the calculation for the next graph and plot it as well. So the next graph's equation is 5x 5x minus 2y is equal to 0. 5x minus 2y is equal to 0. Let's first plot truth table. X, y, 0, 1, minus 1 will be the values of y which we will take. So 5 multiplied by 0 minus 2y is equal to 0. When x is 0, I forgot to write that, when x is equal to 0. So this will become minus 2y is equal to 0. And y is equal to 0 by minus 2, which is nothing but 0. 0 divided by anything is 0. Then when x is equal to 1, 5 bracket 1 minus 2y is equal to 0. So 5 minus 2y is equal to 0. So minus 2y is equal to minus 5. And 2y is equal to 5. So y is equal to 5 by 2. So y is equal to 2.5. Y is equal to 2.5. Then when x is equal to minus 1. When x is equal to minus 1. 5 bracket minus 1 minus 2y is equal to 0. Minus 5 minus 2y is equal to 0. Minus 2y is equal to 5. And y is equal to 5 by minus 2. So y is equal to minus 2.5. Minus 2.5. Okay, great. So it was not so difficult, right? 0, 0, 1, 2.5, minus 1, minus 2.5. Let's plot it. So the second equation is 0, 0, 1, 2.5 and minus 1, minus 2.5. Okay. So we have got three more points. See, the earlier red line which we had got, was the was the graph of the first equation. So that red line will not definitely not pass through these three points, right? Because these three points are plotted as per the second equation. That's a new equation, correct? So for that we have to draw a new line. Let's draw it. Okay, here we go. So we see two red lines. Can we give it another color? I don't know how we can, but yeah, we can somehow we can give another color. Here I can't see any other color. Anyways, so we see that both these graphs, they intersect each other at one point. Both these lines, they intersect each other at this point, and that's what I told you. Wherever these two graphs of these two equations intersect each other, you have to find its x and y coordinate. So what is the x coordinate? So x coordinate of this point where these two lines intersect is minus 2. X coordinate of this point is minus 2 and y coordinate is minus 5. So the solution of these two equations, is x is equal to minus 2 and y is equal to minus 5. That should be the solution, okay, according to the graph. So we have solved these given equations graphically. First we have plotted the first we have calculated and completed the truth table, then we plotted the points, drawn the graph, and wherever the graphs intersected are the values of x and y, minus 2 and minus 5. Let's check our answer. So minus 2 and minus 5. See exactly how our graph has turned up, exactly how it is looking like. Only thing that, you know, see how they have made their graph more informative. They have written the coordinates of all the points, right? And they have also written the equations on the graph. So that's how you can make your graph more informative. Okay, Now, next question, we have to draw the graphs of these two equations and plot 3 points per line. That's what we do. So this is plotting will be as per our regular convention, like how we do regularly. Okay, but after that, after the first question, plotting and drawing the graph is not a problem. That will be done. Okay, so let's do it. I'll just show you. Okay, so this is done. Let's get rid of this and these points and this and these points. Okay, so these are done. Okay, so we have our two new graphs, two new equations. So what are the equations? Equations are 3x minus y minus 2 is equal to 0. Let's see. 3x minus y minus 2 is equal to 3x minus y minus 2 is equal to 0. Yeah, that's what it is. And 2x plus y minus 8 is equal to 0. 2x plus y minus 8 is equal to 0. Absolutely correct. So you know how to fill the truth table. Now, if I tell you that you have to do the calculation with x, the value of x being 0, 1 and minus 1, and fill the value of y, then complete the truth table. Can you do that? Yes, definitely you can. So after drawing the truth table, what will happen is you will get three set of points for each equation. Draw a line passing through those 3 points. Okay, so those lines will be like this and like this. Okay, so this is how you will get the lines. This is how your graphs will look like. Remember that. Okay, remember that. You can also see this is a solved example. So they will give you a sample graph in the solution of the solved example. But see, this is how your graph will look like. Now, how to draw the graph, how to plot the points, how to do the calculation, that we have discussed multiple times till now. But what matters over here is the next question. Let's read that. It says that write down the coordinates of the point of intersection and the area of the triangle formed by the lines and the x-axis. Write down the coordinates of the point of intersection of these two lines. The points intersect, as per the graph, the points intersect at 2, 4. See, the x coordinate of this point where the two lines intersect is 2. And the y coordinate of this point is 4. So 2, 4 is the point of intersection. And what else they are asking? Area of the triangle formed by the line and the x-axis. Now see, there is a triangle, if you can see, which is formed by the line and the x-axis. That triangle is from here. You see this, 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 and here. Okay, I cannot, let me see if I can name these points. Yeah, so this is one point. Let me name the point as, okay, let me remove this first and this one, and let me name the point as 2, 4. Okay, can you see this point? Yes, 2, 4. Okay, label it as A. Can you see the A? Okay, the next point I want you to label is this point. Okay, 0.667, 0. Okay, let's see. 0.667, 0. Can you see that point? Blue point. Label it. Name it B. Okay. And one more point over here. 4, 0. So we have the third point. 4, 0. Okay. Label it. Label it. And name it C. Okay. So do you see ABC? You have to find the area of this triangle ABC. Area of this triangle ABC. So what is the area of a triangle? Remember, what is the question? The question is, they are asking you to find the area. First, they are asking you for the point of intersection, that is 2, 4, and the area of the triangle formed by the lines and the x-axis. So what is the area of triangle? area of triangle is half into base into height. Okay, what is the base here? BC is the base. So what is BC? See, this point is 0.667 and this point is 4. So if you subtract 4 minus 0.667, you will get the base. See, 0.667 can be partially called as 2 by 3. And it is 2 by 3. Basically, this point is 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 and this point is 4. 4 minus 2 by 3, if you do, you will get the base. And the height is from this point, perpendicular distance from A to BC, which is 4. Let's find the area. Let me show you how to find the area. So, as per me, area is equal to half into base into height. The base is 4 minus 2 by 3. So 12 minus 2 by 3, that is 10 by 3. 10 by 3 is the base. So that is half into base is 10 by 3 multiplied by the height. What is the height? Height is 4. Okay, so 2s are 4. So we get 20 by 3. That is 6 2 by 3. Correct? 6 2 by 3 square units. That is the area. Or 6.67. 6.67 is also perfectly fine. Okay, so this is the area. That is how you find the area. Okay, let's check if the answer is correct. So, the point of intersection is 2 comma 4 and the area is 6 2 by 3 square units, right? See the base the same way they have found the base like how I did. So there is no confusion now in how we are dealing with the graphs, correct? You can also use this graphing calculator. Okay, this is very informative and it's a fun thing to use. You will get so many insights that you will actually start liking doing geometry, coordinate geometry. Okay, now let's do the last question. We are on the final question. This is our final question. Let me just open the other page. Yeah. Great. Okay, cool. Let's read the question and find out what is happening. See, this is one typical question, okay, which is there only in your textbook, your exercise. Generally, we don't see these kind of questions in other boards and other textbooks. But your board and your textbook has chosen this question. And this is, you can say on a difficulty level, it is challenging. Okay, and there are few, I think two more similar questions in the exercise 27B. You will find them. But if you try to understand this question, you will be able to solve that also. So here, basically, the challenging part is understanding the question and the second is plotting the graph. Because the scales will be tweaked, changed. Right? So both the things will, you know, will be challenging. Let's see. Let's make it easier for you. So question says that in a factory, the cost of manufacturing X articles is rupees 20 plus 2X. In a factory, the cost of manufacturing X articles is rupees 20 plus 2X. And selling price of X articles is rupees 2.5X. Remember, we have the cost price of X articles and we have selling price of X articles. Shall we note them down? Cost price of X articles is equal to rupees 20 plus 2X. Selling price of X articles is equal to rupees 2.5x. On the same graph paper with the same axis, draw two graphs. First for the cost of manufacturing against the number of articles. Cost of manufacturing against number of articles, and second for the selling price against number of articles. Okay, so see, they are asking you to make two truth tables because they want you to draw two graphs. In these two truth tables, they are asking you, in the first one, they are asking you to draw a graph for cost of manufacturing against number of articles. Yahan pe cost of manufacturing and yahan pe hai number of articles. Okay. So, yes. And the second truth table is for selling price and the number of articles. Selling price and number of articles. Okay, so this is the thing. In a factory, the cost of manufacturing X articles is 20 plus 2x. Remember. So, remember, when X is equal to 1, shall we take 1, 2, 3? Or how do we want to take? See, here, I think before taking anything as X or Y, we should read the question ahead. Take 2 centimeter as 10 articles is equal to 10 articles on one axis. And 2 centimeter is equal to rupees 20 on the other axis. See, if 2 centimeter or 2 blocks is 10 article, one block will be 5 article. So do you understand how they want you to show the graph? I will show you. They want you to show the graph like this. Sorry, let me zoom out. Yes, like this. They want you to show the graph like this, such that on X and Y axis, let me just make some changes over here. Step should be 5, right? Is it correct, the steps 5? No, let me zoom out. Yeah, now I'll make step 1. Wait. Okay, how to change this step as 5 and this one as 5. Yeah, I think step 5 is perfect. Okay, yes. So this is how they want. Each block, you have to number it as 5 units. Yeah, this is how they want. Each centimeter block will be numbered as 5 units because they want you to take in the question. In the question, they want you to take 2 centimeter as 10 article, means 1 centimeter as 5 article. And on the other axis, they want you to take 2 centimeter as 20 rupees. Okay. So I will take the price, that is cost price and selling price, on Y axis. Okay. So 20 rupees, right? 2 centimeter as 20 rupees. So I think I have to change here. The step on Y axis should not be 5. It should be 10. You see the change now? This is how it will look like. In fact, this is how it will look like. This is how it will look like. Okay, so here there is no need of negative quadrants. second, third, fourth, because cost price and number of articles, selling price and number of articles cannot be negative, right? So only the first quadrant will be used, and this is how it will look like. This is how it will look like. Okay, let's read the question ahead. This is your scale, which I have already disclosed with you. ठीक है, चलो अभी आगे क्या बोला है. प्रोवाइड फॉर एक्स अप टू 80. प्रोवाइड फॉर एक्स अप टू 80. एक्स अप टू 80 मतलब क्या है? नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स अप टू 80. अच्छा, मतलब 80 से ज्यादा नहीं लेना है या 80 तक लेना है. ठीक है, तो नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स को हम लोग हाँ ठीक है 10 के मल्टीपल्स पे ले सकते हैं हम लोग अप टू 80. ठीक है, तो नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल को मैं लेता हूँ 10, 20, 30. इधर भी लेता हूँ मैं 10, 20, 30. सिंपल हो जाएगा ना फिर. चलो, अगर आर्टिकल्स 10 है तो कॉस्ट प्राइस कितनी होगी? कॉस्ट प्राइस का फॉर्मूला क्या है? कॉस्ट ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ एक्स आर्टिकल इज 20 प्लस 2x. x की जगह मैंने 10 डाला तो नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स को मैं x ले रहा हूँ. ठीक है, ये x है और ये y है. उल्टा लिखा है मैंने, x है और y. ठीक है, अगर नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स मैंने x ले लिए, 10 ले लिया x की जगह पे, तो कॉस्ट कितनी हो जाएगी? 20 प्लस 2 इंटू 10, दैट इज 20. 20 प्लस 20 कितना हो जाएगा? 40. अगर नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल 20 ले लिया तो 22 इज 40, 40 प्लस 20 60. अगर नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल मैंने 30 ले लिया तो 32 इज 60, 60 प्लस 20 80. मिल गए कोऑर्डिनेट्स. क्या है कोऑर्डिनेट्स? देखो, ये x नीचे है, y ऊपर है. ठीक है, तो फर्स्ट कोऑर्डिनेट है 10 40, 10 40, 20 60, 30 80. लेट्स प्लॉट. ओके, लेट्स इंसर्ट अ टेबल. क्या बोला था मैंने? 10 40. ठीक है, 10 40 आ गया. उसके बाद क्या आया पॉइंट? 20, 20 60, 20 60, वो भी आ गया. और नेक्स्ट पॉइंट कौन सा था? 30 80. इसमें आएगा नहीं, दिखेगा नहीं, लेकिन मैं तुम्हें दिखाता हूं अभी. ये देखो, थोड़ा जूम आउट करेंगे तो 30 80 भी दिखेगा. दिख रहा है 30 80? चलो जूम इन करके वापस अपने ओरिजिनल इस पे आ गए, लेआउट पे. सो दिस इज योर फर्स्ट ग्राफ, योर बेसिकली फर्स्ट लाइन विच विल पास थ्रू दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स. देखते हैं वो क्या होता है. ठीक है, तो एक्चुअली वी नो के y क्या है. y इज 20 प्लस 2x. लिख सकते हैं ना हम लोग, y इज इक्वल टू 20 प्लस 2x. y क्या है? कॉस्ट प्राइस. x क्या है? नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स. ये 20 प्लस 2x इज नथिंग बट y. सो y इज इक्वल टू 20 प्लस 2x हमारा पहला इक्वेशन है. y इज इक्वल टू 20 प्लस 2x. इसको यहां पे लिख दे, y इज इक्वल टू 20 प्लस प्लस 2x. ठीक है, इज इट पासिंग थ्रू ऑल द थ्री पॉइंट्स? वेरी गुड, लेट्स गो अहेड एंड एंटर वन मोर टेबल. ठीक है, इसको हम फिल करेंगे आराम से. ओके, अब क्या आगे? नेक्स्ट. नेक्स्ट इज द नेक्स्ट ट्रुथ टेबल. अब यहां पे सेलिंग प्राइस ऑफ एक्स आर्टिकल इज 2.5x है. एक्स की जगह पे क्या आएगा? नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स. और 2.5x की जगह पे सेलिंग प्राइस, मतलब y इज इक्वल टू 2.5x हो जाएगा ना. y इज द आउटकम, द सेलिंग प्राइस, द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. सो y इज इक्वल टू 2.5x हम पहले से ही लिख देते हैं. अच्छा, अगर x 10 है तो y कितना हो जाएगा? 25. राइट, x 10 है तो y कितना हो जाएगा? 25. x 20 है तो y कितना हो जाएगा? 20 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 2.5 कितना होता है? 50. और x 30 है तो y कितना हो जाएगा? x 30 है तो y हो जाएगा 75. x 30 है तो y कितना हो जाएगा? 75. So 25, 10, 50, 20, 75, 30. Let's plot them. 25, 10, 25, 10. Oh, I'm sorry. मैंने उल्टा उल्टा लिख दिया. 10, 25 होना चाहिए. 10, 25. 10, 25. 20, कितना आया था? 50. ठीक है. और नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट इज 30, 75. 30 आर्टिकल्स की सेलिंग प्राइस कितनी हो जाएगी? 75. 30, 75. एंड व्हाट इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ दिस? इक्वेशन इज इक्वल टू y इज इक्वल टू 2.5x. y इज इक्वल टू 2.5x. इज इट पासिंग थ्रू ऑल द थ्री ब्लैक पॉइंट्स? यस, एब्सोल्युटली. डू यू सी नाउ दिस टू लाइंस? दीज आर योर टू ग्राफ्स of the two equations which we have just figured out. ठीक है, तो ये तो हो गया तुम्हारा calculation, तुम्हारा truth table, तुम्हारा equation, तुम्हारा plotting, सब कुछ हो गया. तुम्हें सब समझ में आया, calculation कैसे किया वो भी समझ में आया. अभी करना क्या? Determine the number of articles to be manufactured and sold to reach break-even point, no profit and no loss. इसका क्या मतलब है? इसका ये मतलब है कि तुम्हें वो नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स ढूंढने हैं जो तुम अगर मैन्युफैक्चर करोगे तो तुम ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट पे पहुंच जाओगे. मतलब यू विल हैव नो प्रॉफिट, नीदर प्रॉफिट नॉर लॉस. नीदर प्रॉफिट नॉर लॉस का मतलब क्या है पता है? सेलिंग प्राइस एंड कॉस्ट प्राइस इज द सेम. सेलिंग प्राइस एंड कॉस्ट प्राइस इज द सेम. अब यहां पे तो दिख रहा है कि इफ आई एम मैन्युफैक्चरिंग जस्ट 10 आर्टिकल्स, मेरा कॉस्ट 40 हो रहा है और मेरा सेलिंग प्राइस 25 है, मतलब लॉस है. इवन इफ आई एम मैन्युफैक्चरिंग 30 आर्टिकल्स, मेरा कॉस्ट 80 है और सेलिंग प्राइस 75 है, अभी भी लॉस है. तो मतलब क्या है, मुझे ज्यादा आर्टिकल सेल करने पड़ेंगे. बट हाउ मेनी? आई डोंट नो दैट, बट माई ग्राफ विल टेल मी दैट. सो लेट्स टेक हेल्प फ्रॉम द ग्राफ. सो बात यह है कि ये ग्राफ जहां पे इंटरसेक्ट करेगा वो पॉइंट इंपॉर्टेंट है. वो कौन सा पॉइंट है पता है? ये वाला पॉइंट, this point. And I want you to label this point. What is this? 40, 100. 40, 100. Shall we label this point? Yes. So 40, 100. ठीक है, इसको हम लेबल कर देंगे. 40, 100 को लेबल कर देंगे. दिख रहा है 40, 100 तुम लोगों को? So what is this 40, 100 point? This is the point where these two graphs are intersecting each other. This is the point where two graphs are intersecting each other. इसका मतलब क्या है? 40 articles, ये x-axis article वाला है और y-axis उसकी cost है. 40 articles अगर मैंने बनाए तो उसकी cost price भी 100 होगी और उसकी selling price भी 100 होगी. और cost price और selling price अगर दोनों same है, इसका मतलब क्या है? No profit, no loss. ये कैसे पता चला हमको? Because ये दोनों lines इस पॉइंट से जा रही है. मतलब ये दोनों लाइंस के लिए जब x की वैल्यू 40 होगी तो y की वैल्यू 100 होगी. मतलब कॉस्ट प्राइस भी 100 और सेलिंग प्राइस भी 100, मतलब नो प्रॉफिट नो लॉस. फॉर हाउ मेनी आर्टिकल्स? 40 आर्टिकल्स. सो इसका जो आंसर है, नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स टू बी मैन्युफैक्चर्ड एंड सोल्ड टू रीच ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट इज 40. द प्रॉफिट मेड व्हेन 60 आर्टिकल्स आर मैन्युफैक्चर्ड एंड सोल्ड. The profit made when 60 articles are manufactured and sold. चलो ग्राफ का ही हेल्प लेते हैं. 60 articles के लिए क्या होगा? तो 60 article कहाँ है? Can you see 60 वाला line over here? ठीक है, 60 देखते रहना. ये देखो 60, ये नीचे दिख रहा है तुम्हें? मैं ये ग्राफ को 60 के करीब ला रहा हूँ. देखो आ गया, देखो 60 के करीब. अब जब 60 articles बनते हैं तो ये जो तुम्हारी पर्पल लाइन है, पर्पल लाइन, वो पर्पल लाइन कौन सा इक्वेशन है पता है? y इज इक्वल टू 20 + 2x. y इज इक्वल टू 20 + 2x किसका इक्वेशन है? कॉस्ट प्राइस का. ठीक है, तो पर्पल लाइन कॉस्ट प्राइस की लाइन है. तो बताओ मैं 60 आर्टिकल्स बताता हूँ, बनाता हूँ, तो उसकी कॉस्ट प्राइस कितनी होती है? और प्राइस है वाई एक्सिस पे, तो ये रही प्राइस, कितनी आई प्राइस, 140 रुपीज। हाँ लेकिन जब मैं 60 आर्टिकल्स बेचता हूँ तो मुझे कितना सेलिंग प्राइस मिलता है, और सेलिंग प्राइस की जो लाइन है ये लाइट ब्लू लाइन है, ये लाइट ब्लू लाइन का जो वाई कोऑर्डिनेट है वो क्या है, 150। मतलब 60 आर्टिकल्स जब मैं मैन्युफैक्चर करता हूँ तो कॉस्ट 140 रुपीज आता है, 60 आर्टिकल्स जब मैं सेल करता हूँ तो कॉस्ट 150 रुपीज आता है, तो प्रॉफिट कितना हुआ, सेलिंग प्राइस माइनस कॉस्ट प्राइस, 150 माइनस 140। ये तुम्हें तुम्हारा जो ग्राफ ड्रॉ करोगे ना उससे डिटरमाइन करना पड़ेगा, एंड इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फिट दिस ग्राफ इन वन फुल पेज, इसलिए जो स्केल है ना उसको थोड़ा ट्वीक करना, करने के लिए हेजिटेट मत करना। अगर तुम्हें लगता है कि तुम्हारा स्केल फिट नहीं हो रहा है तो सिर्फ फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट बनाओ पूरे ग्राफ पेपर पे, सिर्फ फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट, और फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट पे प्लॉट करो, हो जाएगा प्लॉट, ठीक है, हो जाएगा प्लॉट फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट पे, याद रखना उसको। तो वी गॉट द आंसर दैट नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स टू बी, इसको चेक कर लेंगे हम, बट वी गॉट द आंसर नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स टू रीच टू बी मैन्युफैक्चर टू रीच ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट इज 40, एंड टोटल प्रॉफिट मेड व्हेन 60 आर्टिकल्स आर मैन्युफैक्चर्ड एंड सोल्ड इज ₹10। ठीक है, 40 एंड ₹10, ये हमारा आंसर से, लेट्स चेक देम। ओके ठीक है, तो ये देखो ऐसा ग्राफ बना था, हमारा भी ऐसे ही बना था, इन्होंने भी फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट लेके पूरा सॉल्व किया है, हमने भी वैसे ही किया, एंड नंबर ऑफ आर्टिकल्स दैट मस्ट बी मैन्युफैक्चर्ड टू सोल्ड एंड सोल्ड टू रीच ब्रेक इवन पॉइंट इज 40 एंड प्रॉफिट मेड इज ₹10। समझ में आया? सो ऐसे क्वेश्चंस तुम्हारे एक्सरसाइज में भी है, मैं एग्जैक्टली बता भी सकता हूँ कौन से क्वेश्चन है, क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 है ऐसा, और एक था यार मैंने देखा था, क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 तो पक्का ही ऐसा है, बाकी तो मुझे नहीं दिख रहा है अभी, शायद चेंज हो गया होगा, तुम्हारी बुक में देखना शायद है कि नहीं। ओके ग्रेट ग्रेट ग्रेट, 27A, 27B, 27 चैप्टर पूरा कंप्लीट हो गया। सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड एंड यू एंजॉयड दिस चैप्टर, वेरी स्मॉल चैप्टर, इसके बाद वो जो लास्ट चैप्टर है 28 वो भी खत्म कर देंगे, ठीक है, तो पूरा अपना जो कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री का यूनिट है वो खत्म हो जाएगा। इससे क्या होगा पता है कि तुम्हारा एक जो एस्पेक्ट है वो पूरा कॉन्सेप्ट उसका क्लियर हो जाएगा, दैट इज कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री, तुम्हें ए बी सी डी सब कुछ पता है उसका, ए टू जेड, यू नो एवरीथिंग, जितना 9th में 10th में पता होना चाहिए तुम्हें सब पता है, 10th में तो खैर अभी और भी कुछ चीजें समझेंगे हम, बट 9th के लेवल पे तो तुम चैंपियन हो जाओगे, ठीक है। सो आई शैल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो देन, बाय बाय।